This is a long-ass technology tree for a little game like this. Hi guys, I'm Neodyinamite and welcome to Egypt! Pre-civilization, a luxury pre-civilization Egypt! This is a little series of games that's like available on general on the internet from what I know, from what I have read on the Steam reviews. But on Steam there are currently two games. Pre-civilization Egypt, which is the second game, and pre-civilization, I think, Marble, which takes place in Greece. Now, if you like want to compare this game to anything, I think that the closest thing you could compare it to is like the maybe old Civilization games, like the older ones, you know, because the game is very simple. This is basically a coffee breaker, you know, you can have like a little bit of time, you don't want to focus on a game too much, you just want to like play a little bit with during your coffee break, and you don't have like a super high-end PC that's gonna like run freaking, I don't know, four crises at the same time. Crisis games, then this game is probably for you. I've played a little bit of it, but I'm gonna start again from the beginning, because let's just say that my previous civilization was a fucking disaster, alright? So, yeah, where's the fucking choose your prologue? Okay, so I don't know what the fuck I'm supposed to do. We're supposed to, we can choose from some of those things. Like those are like the, I don't know, like the beginning aspects of our civilization in Egypt. Basically, the game is... from what I heard, the game is history accurate. I don't know. I know a little bit of ancient history, but the problem is that Egypt is not the strongest of my aspects. And I think I know a little bit, I can say a little bit about how the culture went, how they progressed, how the, you know, what was the military based on, what was the economy based on, but I completely have no idea how the dynasties were back in the day. I think I remember only the one of the last dynasties, and that's basically it. So let's pick something, because this is taking too long. So what we can pick? So I'm guessing this is like the easy difficulty. This is the medium difficulty apparently, and this is like the, I don't know, bad events happens more often than good. Okay, that's good. So those are probably like this is like higher difficulty, and those are the aspects that we can focus on. So we can focus on production. We can focus on cost of workers and buildings. This actually sounds good. Recommended for beginners. This is what? A lot of resources on the maps. Sounds cool. Good events happens more often. Enemies' armies are 20% weaker. Well, I think we can deal with the armies. That's not so good. That's supposed to be safe. That's supposed to be Anubis. I don't know. Let's take this one. Hope it's gonna be... Enter your name. Huh. Neo. I don't know how to fucking spell my name. The great pharaoh, Neo, from the Dynasty of Explosions. Would you like to play the tutorial again? No, I think I'm fine with it, for now. We'll see how it's gonna go. So basically, like, the game has, from what I know, has two phases for now. This is what I learned, is that first you have, like, the place when the city will stand, the great the great capital of your kingdom, of the Egypt, and then later on you're supposed to take control of the entire of Egypt. That's how it's supposed to work, I think. Mission, colonization. We came from a large tribe that suffered from overpopulation. We left our homes and we are looking for happiness in the new lands. To gain a foothold in a new place, we need to increase the size of the tribe. Goal, increase the tribe to 3 workers. Bonus hunting plus 1, reward 1 time plus 5 food. So yeah, basically you need to like gather food, working production thingy, you know, it's like a little bit like if you play Civilization, you get the idea. So you got this lovely motherfucker who's supposed to be a worker who's like currently not doing a damn shit, so we're gonna send him here. Go work for me, you goddamn. Okay, population 8 people, and this soon will grow to a great freaking city. Primitive tribe. Our tribe is still a primitive stage of development. It's a nomadic and survives mostly by hunting and gathering. We live in temporary huts. No bonuses. For fortune development, we should discover Baduri culture. Okay, well, like, everything is still blocked, so I can't do a damn shit. Can I get this guy, please? No, I cannot get this guy. So I'm gonna send this guy to find me some fucking stuff. Find me a more suitable land. Come on. And there you go. Nice. So, yeah, this is city, right? This is gonna be later on your city. This entire map is gonna be like your big ass freaking city. And later on we're gonna move to the like to the actual Egypt. That's gonna be like, you know, upper, lower kingdom. Okay, so let's get this guy over here. So maybe we're gonna get more food, so we're gonna get more workers. Population, still 8. Yes, now I have a freaking worker. So I'm gonna send him here to scout me more areas. Hopefully he'll find something. 12 people! How did that happen? I have no fucking clue. Still waiting, nothing happening. Mission colonization. Oh, I have this already. Never mind. Okay, he has discovered something. Show me. That's a bullshit. Production found, 3. scouts come across a small settlement. It seems to be abandoned, but taking a closer look at the houses, they found something useful. One time, plus 3 hammers. So this is actually production. So yeah, you have like, you need food to, you know, to give food to your people, to like hire more workers. Workers basically are everything. Workers are sent as emissaries, workers working at the working camp, so they give you production. Workers work in the temple, so they give you faith. They're working in somewhere else that they're gonna give you, I think, knowledge or something like that. They also work in the blacksmith, so they can produce weapons for the army. They also work as freaking envoys, and you can send to other cities and kingdoms. So like basically, the workers are basically the key in this game. They do everything for some unknown reason. Okay, we can now discover this. Accumulated culture. Oh, culture, that's the thing. Like religion and culture. Okay, what is it? The accumulated culture here turns into technology breakthroughs. Let's see. Okay, so this is nice. This is a long ass technology tree for a little game like this. It's fucking way too long. Oh, look, slavery. Would you look at fucking that? Okay, let's see. What is this? Experimental breeding. The first decimated animals were goats. They gave people meat, skins, and milk. Growth plus 1 every turn. Okay. This is what? Growth plus 2 every turn. So this is the culture. I don't think I need that for now. Scouting duration minus 1. I think I'm gonna go for the food. So I'll be able to like get additional worker. There you go, plus 1. So now I have to like just wait till I'm gonna get a free worker. What I'm gonna do? I'm gonna send this guy over here. Breeding spam. Okay. Sometimes hunting bring wild sheep and goats to the settlement. Oh, hunters. For years, the animals remained half wild and did not breed in captivity. Feeding the lambs and kids from the first day solved the problem. No shit. So this is basically like you're learning history without playing a historical game, like completely history-focused game. Like, you know, we have those games that are like completely only about history. This is actually a game that at the same time teaches you a little bit about stuff. Okay, we have found this thing, and this is completely bullshit because I cannot do anything with this. I can get another discovery though. Let's get this thing. Thank you very freaking much. Cult of the Falcon. Hunters notice that the Falcon is a very skilled predator. Incredibly fast, precise, and strong. Respect for his bird eventually grew into a veneration. People began to pray the Falcon for luck in the hand. And basically, later on this thing, I think, this is the Falcon? The Falcon, I think, later become the Godra, right? That's how it developed? I don't actually remember. Send this guy over here. Next turn. 12 people. Great. Like, we are progressing nicely. Get this thing as well. So, a little bit of history, maybe, please? No? What gonna happen? This thing is covered. Oh, yeah, because I have lowered the scouting for one, so they're basically giving me stuff. What's this? This is the thing? Dogs were the first friends of man. The Egyptians were impressed by their ability to track and smell danger. Dogs were used for hunting, guarding homes, and they were very respected. Egyptians believed that after death, dogs serve people as guardians in the realm of the dead. Oh, so that's how the cult of Anubis later on was probably born? I completely don't know the beginning of Egypt. I know that they like later on they tried to focus around on the borders of Nile. To get the freaking farms things, like that's basically how Egypt grows because they knew how to farm around Nile, the river. Mermaid culture. The north of us is the delta of Nile. Light-skinned people have appeared. They have made great strides in what agriculture, breeding cattle, and they're able to mold pots to build houses. They're ahead of us in development. Not for fucking long. Just to fucking wait. Take this guy over here so we're gonna get more food and hopefully, there you go, another fucking slave. I mean worker. Our tribe has successfully multiplied and secured population, the new land. Okay. Our gatherers noticed that the grains, which accidentally fell on fragile soil sprout plentiful shots. It would be interesting to see if we'll be able to repeat this and get more food. Discover experimental farming, build fields of grain into areas. Building price minus 20. Bonus building plan, okay. Award one time, 10 foot. Okay. How the actual fuck I'm supposed to do this? Discover, okay, I need to like discover the thingy first. But I don't have the... I need to wait for culture. I'm gonna send this guy over here because I will soon need hammers. Oh good, it's raining. Abandoned ruins watered the savannah and its bloomishment. The regeneration Sahara shined green and is full of living creatures. Hunting, gathering, farming, cattle bring one more food. Remaining two turns. Great. Now I need to get the... experimental farming. Experiment with the wheat. Yes, wheat. Smacking wheat. Gather some plenty, notice that the seed dropped on the ground will generate after a successful experiment with wheat and barley farming appeared. Fucking finally. So how the hell I'm supposed to... Oh yeah, I need to like build this thing. Those fields richly fertilized by the Nile mud could provide the richest harvest in the world. That is actually freaking true. Like, technically, if we would... Nile back in the day, I think, was the most fertile land in the entire world. Nobody has... Nobody had this kind of river in any country. Maybe in Brazil, but I don't know the like people over there living back then. Probably were. Okay, send this guy here so he can build stuff. It's gonna take 2 turns. He's gonna be missing one freaking hammer. Scouts from a hostile tribe were spotted near our settlement. They have not decided what to do with us yet, but nothing good will come from such neighbors. New threat available. Probability of attack. Great. Go fuck yourself. It's like, really? Okay, I'm gonna send this guy here. Because we need to get... There you go. Farms! The myth about the ancestor Falcon. Many generations have passed since our tribe began to honor the Falcon. Even the elders can no longer remember how it all started. But people believe that the great Falcon Horus founded our tribe and was our ancestor. That's a bunch of bullshit. Okay, I have one free guy, so I'm gonna send you here. Can I discover something? I can. Baskets were used for housing storage. Cattle eat a lot more than small goats, but are much more beneficial. Let's go for the... No, let's go for the food. So I'll be able to afford more freaking workers. Buildings! We can build one more farm. But I don't have any men to do so I still need to like gather the freaking hammer. So yeah, scouts reported that our neighbors, the Flaxflower tribe, considers us weak and gathers warriors to burn our settlement, but they still can change their mind. Become friends with them or incinerate it, increase the tribe size to 5 so they see that we have a lot of something and we are dangerous. And now the fun starts. Now it's gonna be the fun part, because now we need to like freaking focus on everything and hopefully we won't die. Because that's how I died on one of the turns, don't fucking question. It was a bad way to go. Next turn, please. Oh, I could develop something, forgot. Come on, give me a good land. There you go. I'm gonna move the guy from this thing here, because he's now gonna give me two food and hammers. Gonna develop this thing. There you freaking go. Gonna send this guy over here. That's not enough hammers. Okay, more scouting then. We need to get like a good production thingy somewhere. Can get one more guy from the... There's nothing here. God damn it. This. Glory to the gods! Scouts have reported that the rumors about our tribe getting stronger have reached our neighbors. They are changing their mind about attacking us. The threat has passed. Good. What? I have already 5-9 people? How many people are I supposed to have? I thought I was supposed to have 9, not 5. Okay, whatever. 30 people. Great tribe. Many people. I still don't need enough. Come on, give me. You discover those two things. Besides Horus, a priest suggests that we begin honor and make sacrifices to the new animal god. It will become additional burden, but this god will help us for certain. What will you decide? That's a good fucking question. We already have the good Falcon, other gods are not associated to us. Oh, you will be surprised. I don't know how new religions were born back in the day, but this is like fucking interesting. Let's do this. New god! Animal god, maybe it will help us as well as the Falcon with our affairs. Yeah, but what kind of god? I don't see any... Who is the not god? Who am I supposed to worship? The great Bambaloo? The great goat? The great, I don't know, crocodile maybe? Early rituals, complex spells, rituals, dances and sacrifices. The Egyptians believed that those were ways to affect the spiritual world. Maybe. Primitive dwellings, farming has allowed people to move to a settled life and now they need permanent houses. Flax, cultivation of flax. Fibres of flax become a breakthrough in the creation of clothes. People learn to make threads and cloth. Let's do the primitive housing. So we're gonna give our people housings. But still, I need to, like, there you go. I'm gonna get one of the guys who's gonna... He's gonna be doing the building stuff. It's another farm over there. Grow over the culture of the Falcon. Cult of the Falcon. Thanks to our wisdom, our tribe grows and develops. Rumors about our spread and people say that the Sky Falcon himself helps us. Neighboring tribes have heard about this miracle and have begun to honor him as well. It's better for them that they fucking do. Okay, can I do something else here that would not be a complete disaster? How many... Oh, I need a lot of food to get this thing. Okay, let's assume the first second is gonna be good. I need to, like, get the farm as soon as possible so we're gonna get more... I should have probably built the farm straight away, didn't I? But no, of course, I'm a dumb fuck and I forgot completely to do that. Okay, let's get this thing. Thank you very freaking much. People believe that the divine powers long before the era of ancient Egyptians. But with the advance of the Neolithic, the rituals become much more complicated. The first priestess appeared and people believe that only they knew all the secret prayers and rituals. Oh my god, what the fuck? Cults. Okay. Forefathers offer sacrifices to the spirit of the ancestors, asking them for guidance, guiding us and protecting us from evil. Falcon Horus. Ask the all-seeing falcon for good luck on hunting. This is fishing, okay, whatever. Pray to the heavenly cow who gives breath to stars for the fragility of our land and cattle. Cattle farming and cattle brings one more food during free. Okay, I'm gonna get this thing. The goddess Nut is the sky over our heads, and she prevents us from the house of space, the mother of all living things. She cares about cattle, please blesses plants to make them grow, increases our tribe, and gives wealth. Whatever! I still need more people! Come on, give me one more guy. There you go. I don't know why I have overpopulation. No worries, I need to, like, worry. We need to get the freaking house very soon. And the farm should appear. There you go. 5. We know the secret of farming. It's a breakthrough. We can spend less time hunting and gathering. And we can grow food by ourselves. Okay. Cool. We know the secret of farming, grow food. Now we can feed the tribe. It is time to build the settlement and start to settle. Increase the tribe to 8. Okay, I need like 2 more. Bonus workers, creation price. Cool, that's also a thing I need. So this, primitive dwellings. We transitioned to settled life. The first dwellings were primitive huts of branches, chaff and clay. Don't fucking sue. Put this guy here. Do I have... I don't have the resources. What's this? Okay, this is the thing. Okay, whatever. Next turn. I just want to build a freaking village, you know? 5 turns before the trial of the Sanctuary of the Falcon. What? Oh, fuck. The trial of this Falcon. Okay, what is this? I bet this have not enough resources to make the thingy, whatever. Go fuck yourself. This may not end actually good. I think I'm way too behind. Or am I? I don't know. Okay, need this guy to be here, so we're gonna get more resources as soon as that is humanly possible. No, send this guy over here. I need to, like, get a good position to get the resources from something. Like, I don't know where, but I need it. Discover. Can I do something with this knowledge? Of course not. Anything new? Oh, okay, we can get this thing. Culture found 7. Autosave complete. Lack of resources. Primitive housing. Whatever. Go fuck yourself. Okay, technically it's okay. I have to, like, just wait for the house to get completed. So just keep pressing the forward button. It's probably a Badari culture. People of the North Middle Egypt. What? Related to ours have achieved outstanding success in Middle Egypt. They have cultivated lands and have built many villages in Cinnamon. They have a layer of nobility which indicates that they moved towards the creation of a state. Oh fuck, I am still in the cave, you know, without the light, and everybody is fucking me. Leaders of the local tribes have gathered and decided to build a sanctuary for the sacred falcon, but they could not agree on which settlement should erect it. Having agreed, the leaders decided that the worthiest settlement would be the one which could finish the construction first. We have worshipped the falcon for a long time, and his honor must belong to us. Okay, need to build the thingy. I need to build the thingy in 10 turns. Okay, that's a fucking disaster. Can I even build this thing? Builders are busy. Fuck! Fuck! This is bad! Can you construct the fucking houses? Because I need them! Horus the Lure, we pray to the fucking Horus for our totem and ask for acceleration the building of the sanctuary. He's not just our ancestor and a born hunter, but also the wisest and all-knowing god. From now on, we will honor him more than ever. God of Horus, Hunter has changed it to Horus the Ruler, okay. Oh, the cult of Horus the Hunter, okay. Accelerating the building of the sanctuary, hunting the Horus, okay, whatever, go fuck yourself. I need to get this thing. Ask, why the fuck I didn't do it? Okay, no, I'm gonna leave that for now, because I want to leave that thing for the sanctuary of the Horus. Okay, the house is ready. Fucking finally. Flood was good, we put the additional crop. What we do with the thingy? Culture growth, save. Let's save the food because we need more workers. If we put part of the harvest away in the granaries, and now we have a grain reserve which will be used for the good of the tribe. Good. So now get this. Yeah, this is the thing, Sanctuary of the Falcon. Yeah, build it. Okay, put this guy here. Okay, now this is what I need. So this is like an event, like from time to time event happens. Like the first event was that our trap was like about to get attacked. This is the second event. We need to like construct thingy, and after if we win those events, the end game score, we're gonna give us more points. So it's like, yeah, you're so freaking awesome because you did something that other people don't manage to do because you're fucking cheating. Anyway, Sanctuary of the Falcon. Other settlements will finish this in 8 turns. Resources, yada 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 yada. Need to do fucking something with this. That's too little! How the fuck I'm supposed. Oh, wait! Yes! Horus! Okay, 11. Still not enough. Need to, like, do something. Oh, come on, think! Think, 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 think! How many turns? They constructed in 7 turns, and I'm, like, still far away in the fucking desert. Okay, I need to, like, think out how I'm gonna do the Falcon Sanctuary so that I'll be able to do it before the enemies, hopefully somehow, I don't know how. I need to like think a good tactic, but for now I'm gonna leave it here because I'm running out of record time and my voice is slowly freaking dying in the middle of freaking Egypt. So thank you guys so much for watching, I hope you enjoyed. If you liked the episode, please press the like button, it helps a lot, and I'll see you all in the next video. Okay, we have a little bit of food, so that's cool. Into group, two groups, hardcore running at its finest. God damn it, I'm already dying, I'm already failing. Something in the bushes, I don't like it. Oh, four? Have to like focus on too many things.